this is a map of England that your mother, who is English,
yes.
Brought over. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
She found it in an antique store. It's out of a book, and she framed it. I went traveling in about 1990, and I'm in Edinburgh looking down in one of the little shops, and what did I discover? But women ripping books apart and painting them. And it suddenly was, oh, did that happen here?
This is mapped by a man named John Speed, whose name is over here in the cartouche. And John Speed was one of the most important of the early British cartographers. Very, very popular because he's British. At that time, most of the cartographers were Dutch. It's from the 17th century, and down here is the date, 1610. That was when this first came out. This one is probably from about 1611, 1612. So it's an early edition. Now, this guy here, Jodocus Hondius, is the guy who actually did the engraving, and he was Dutch.
Oh.
And he was getting started in the business, so there was a Dutch connection. But this is a British map. Now, you talk about the color, and that's actually a very interesting thing, because John Speed maps were from an atlas, and most of the ones that are around were taken out of atlases, which were broken up. They were almost never issued with color. What happened, though, is the British discovered that if they broke apart the atlases and they colored them like this, they sold better. And being a nation of shopkeepers, they said, let's break these atlases, let's color them, and let's sell them. And that really is the beginning of people getting interested in maps, because colored, they're beautiful. But also, it actually increases the value. Unlike a lot of other antiques, with antique maps, if you have an uncolored map and you color it, it often increases the value. This is a very nice example. They're very desirable. This map would probably sell for about $2,000 to $2,200.
Really?